teachers and dear friends. Today I would like to present a paper on meter in general and some speciality of Vedic meters with the syllabic rules of Vedic meters. What is a meter? What is the exact sense of the meter? Then an imaginative idea devoid of emotion cannot be considered as poetry. Among the various poetic elements that contribute to this emotive aspect, meter also has a significant role. The spontaneous outpour of emotion always happens through a suitable meter that is revealed in the mind of the poet at the time of literary creation. In classical period also, the relationship of poetry is accepted as an equipment of poet. Dandin states that the knowledge of poetry is like a boat to those who wish to cross the ocean of poetry. Savidya, now Sthidir Shonam, Gambhiram, Kavya Sagaram. Almost all other early poeticians like Bhamaha, Vamana and Rudrada have stated that erudition in poetry is essential for poetical composition. Dasyagara also considers Chandovijiti as an ingredient to Kavya Vidya. Grihita Vidyoba Vidyaha Kavya Kriyaye Prayadeda Namadhadu Parayane Abhidhana Goshaha Chando Vijitihi Alangara Tandram Cha Kavivid. And Mahima Bhatta also realized the rhythmic nature and potentiality of meter in communicating the emotive element of poetry. So he includes meter also the shabdalangara like yamaka and anuprasa. Adayeva yamaka anuprasa yoriva vrtasyabi shabdalangaratvam ubagadam asmabihi. Thus poeticians accept prosodial knowledge as an equipment for the composition of poetry. The three terms, Chandas, Vrittam and Jadi, are seen profusely used in Sanskrit prosody. Among them, Chandas and Vritta, though they are used as synonyms, have separate meanings in the context of prosody. The word Chandas has various meanings such as to please, to cover and desire. When it means to please, it is derived from the root Chadi. By the Unadi Sutra Chandairadeschachaha, the Pratyaya Asun is added to the root and the Chagara became Chagara by the Sutra Ididonum Haladehe. A Nagara is added and the word Chandas is derived. When it means to cover, it is derived from the root Chadi Sambarane. In Vedic texts, the word Chandas is used to mean both to cover and to please. A mythical account described in Chandogya Upanishad says that the gods who were afraid of death entered into the threefold knowledge, the Trayi. They got themselves covered with the metrical hymns because they got themselves covered with them. The metrical hymns are called Chandas. Yaska also accepts the derivation when he says Chandamsi Chadanath. Shatapada Brahmana accepts the derivation of Chandas meaning to please. The meter is pleased. Chadayan, Prajapati, and hence they are called Chandamsi. Yadasma, Achadayan, Sasmat, Chandamsi. As regards poetry, both these derivations can be accepted as the meter covers the meaning and it pleases the reader. In Bhagavad Gita, Chandas is used to denote Veda collectively. Urdhumula Madashagham, Ashwattham, Prahuragyayam, Chandamsiyasya Parnani. Like here, the world is figuratively depicted as a tree and the Vedas are considered as its leaves. Thus, meters like Anushtup in Vedas are called Chandas. And as Chandas is a very important element in Veda, the Vedas are collectively denoted by this nature. Vrittam and Jadi is also used in in the classical meters, we have to realize what was the differential sense of the both. Vrittam is a term used to denote meters in classical literature generally, but technically classical meters are derived into two categories, Vrittam and Jati. Dandin says, Padyam Chadushpadi Tacha Vrittam Jati Riti Dvidha. Halayuda, while commentating the Sutra Vrittam, says that the classical meter is called Vrittam as it exists in the Vedic meters, like Gayatri, Gayatri Adav Chandasi Vartadaidi Vrittam. They have definite rules in the arrangement of gurus and leghus. Tacha sthira guru leghu tacha sthira guru leghu akshara vinyasam ishyade. Meters like vamshastam indra vamsha todagam and drudavida vilambidam are derived from 12 syllabled chandas named jagadi. Thus, all the classical syllabic meters, vrittas, are originated from Vedic chantases. Bharata also attests this view when he says, Sarvesham chandasamevam vrittani kathidani vai. Abhinagupta gives a different derivation to the term vrittam. Guru Leghu Akshara Niyamena Shradhyada Vartade Yeshu Tani Vrittani Shradhyartatvad. He says that because of the rules of Gurus and Leghus, where exists pleasantness, they are Vrittas. Here it is implied that though so many meters or Vrittas can be derived from each Chandas, those which are pleasing to hear by the laws of Gurus and Leghus only can be actually considered as Vrittas. For example, by the technique called Prasthara, 2048 meters can be produced from Trishtup, but among them about 17 meters which are pleasing to hear are commonly used by the poets. The difference between Vritta and Jati is clearly stated by Gangadasa in Chandomanjari. Vritta Akshara Sankhyadam Jadir Matra Krida Bhaved. Akshara Niyam Aksharir Ganana Yatra Tad Vritta Midi Kathyade Matra Bir Ganana Yatra Sa Jadir Abhidhyade. The meter which is regulated by the number of syllable is called Vrittam, and that which is regulated by the number of matras is called Jati. The word Jati literally means the genus or the true state of anything. So the meters which are grouped as Jati must have been the refined forms of the ballads that have naturally existed among the common folk. As the units of syllabic matras constitute this type of meters, it is also named as matra vritta. This syllabic matra is related to the kala matra, which is the measure of time in music. Because of this reason, it is also called musical meters. When we are coming to the Vedic meters, the earliest available work in Sanskrit literature, the Rig Veda, has been widely accepted as the first poetic composition also. The poetic beauty of Rig Veda is of par excellence. The skill of Vedic poets in handling the language and meter, also expressing their ideas, is also equally attractive. This monumental literary composition includes lyrics, songs, heroic poetry, ballads and dialogues. The rishis who composed the hymns must have been guided by specific canons for metrical expressions that were current in their times. The meters used are well suited to the types of poetry, the ideas expressed in them, and the content exposed. The heroic theme is composed in strongly articulated line of 11 syllables. In the lyrics, where the beautiful variety of descriptions like Ratri and Ushas are found, other meters like Gayatri, Trishtup and Strophe types are found. The scholars who have analyzed the structure and rhythmic nature of Vedic meters observe that they were either basically the same or modifications of meters used in the various languages and dialects of that time, which were derived from the primitive Indo-European, according to E. Vernon Arnold. As works of mechanical art, the meters of the Rigveda stand high above those of modern Europe in variety of motive and in flexibility of form. They seem indeed to bear the same relation to them as the rich harmonies of classical music to the simple melodies of the peasant. Bernard Blackstone's opinion about meter supports the foregoing idea. He says they are the product of whole communities, not of individuals. The Vedic mantras were composed mainly in 14 different meters, from Gayatri to Adhidhridi. It must be noted that all these meters have not come into being simultaneously and had always been in vogue. Regarding the development of the art of versification in Vedic Samhitas, E. Vernon Arnold has analyzed 5 phases. They are, the first one, archaic period; the second one, strophic period; third, the normal period; for the critic period; and the fifth, the popular period. The archaic period can also be called the bardic period or the period of originality. In this period, the Vedic bards were occupied in constructing fresh metrical schemes. It was in this period that the books 7th of Rigveda were written. The next phase is the strophic period, in which different types of strophes were composed. During the normal period, more importance is given to perfection than originality. The 3rd, 4th and 11th mandalas of Rigveda were written in this period. Trishtup and Gayatri were profusely used in these books. In critic period also, more or less Trishtup and Gayatri were used. Many hymns in the book 1st and a few portions in 10th mandala belong to this period. This is the period of transition. Many hymns in the book of 10th were written in popular period. The particularity of this period is that the Trishtup hymns were contaminated by the mixing of Gayatri. We have to understand what are the general characteristics of Vedic meters. Generally, Vedic meters are regulated by the total number of syllables in a stanza without considering the quantity of them. But at the same time, variation in the number of syllables is not considered as a fault. Variation, even by 3 syllables, does not deprive the meter of its technical feature. A stanza consisting of 24 syllables is known as Gayatri. If 1 or 2 syllables are increased or even decreased, it will be considered as Gayatri itself. This flexibility or irregularity can be considered as the general skillfulness of Vedic bards. E. Vernon Arnold observed that apparent irregularity is the result of Vernon Arnold in his text Vedic Meters. He observes that apparent irregularity is the result of the inventive spirit, sometimes leading to the construction of new and harmonious forms, sometimes apparently ending in failure. These flexible characteristics of Vedic meters relating to the number of syllables are not found in classical meters. In Vedic prosody, a syllable is considered as a unit irrespective of Hraswa and Dirgha. Time of uttering syllables, one matra for Hraswa and two matras for Dirgha, was not regarded as a determining element of meter. But the three sound modulations, Udatta, Anudatta and Swarida, were accepted while chanting the stanza. So it can be concluded that Vedic meters are based on the Swara Sangeeta of music, and there is no important role to the time element in the production of the metrical music. The Vedic meters are regulated by the total number of syllables in a stanza. The quantity of a syllables was not considered as a not considered in classical meter, beginning from 24 syllables and adding 4 each up to 76, 14 meters are current in Vedas. Gayatrushni Ganushtub Brhadi Pankti Trishtub Jagadi Jagatyadi Jagadi Shakwadi Adi Shakwadi Ashtyatyashti Dridi Adi Dritya Drityaha. According to another view, there are 21 meters in Vedic texts, beginning from 24 syllables to 104 in the same pattern of ascending order. Chaturvimshati Aksharadini Chaturuttarani. These 24 meters are grouped into three classes: Rishichandas, Adichandas and Kridichandas. Gayatri, Ushnik, Anushtup, Brhadi, Pankti, Trishtup and Jagadi are called Rishichandas. These are the prominent meters in the Vedas. Adijagadi, Shakwari, Adishakwari, Ashti, Atyashti, Dhridi, Adidhridi are called Adichandas. And there are also known as Sangirna Chandas. The Kriti Chandas are also 7 in number. They are Kridihi, Prakridihi, Akridihi, Vigridihi, Sangridihi, Abhigridihi and Utkridihi. Shavanaga calls these 7 varieties as Adichandas. Then firstly we can understand about Rishichandas. Gayatri. A stanza of Rig consisting of 24 syllables is called Gayatri. Normally, there will be 3 lines with 8 syllables each. The first stanza of Rigveda is an example. Agnimile Purohidam, Yagnasya Devam Ruttijam, Hodaram Rekhnadadamam. Sometimes these 24 syllables may be equally arranged in 4 lines. That is, sometimes that can come 8 plus 8 plus 8. In this way, the 24 syllables may be equally arranged in 4 lines. That is 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6. This quatrain is also called Gayatri. It is to be noted that the number of syllables in a line or pada is not rigidly prescribed in Vedic meters. In a stanza also, variation of syllables is common. So all these Vedic meters have a number of varieties. Thus, apart from the normal Gayatri, sometimes we can get 8 varieties of Gayatri also. That is, Padabhangtihi, Ushnigarbha, Pada Nijrutta, Adi Nijrutta, Yavamadhya, Vardhamana, Pradishta, Hrasiyasi. These are the 8 varieties of Gayatri. There is also the difference in the syllables in each line. If that is Padabhangtihi, 3 varieties can come. That is 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5. Sometimes 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 6. Sometimes then 26 syllables. And 4 plus 6 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5. That is 25 syllables. That is also Padabhangtihi. In that variety, Ushnigarbha is 6 plus 7 plus 11. Pada Nijrut, 7 plus 7 plus 7. Nijrut, one syllable is less than the total quantity. So, Pada Nijrut, 7 plus 7 plus 7. Like Adi Nijrut, 7 plus 6 plus 7. Yavamadhya. Then, like Yavamadhya means a variety of Yavamadhya Gayatri, that is the middle portion of the middle portion of Yava, how that was some more larger than the two parts, like 7 plus 10 plus 7, that is first line 7 syllables, and the second line that is 10 syllables, and the third line that is also 7, that is Yavamadhya. Like, so Pradishta is also there. Padan Nijrit Gayatri, Dvibada Gayatri, 12 plus 12. Then, eight varieties of Gayatri we can find out. And in the case of Ushnik also, that is when when the number of syllables in a stanza is 28, it is called Ushnik. Generally, this is also a three-lined meter, like Gayatri, and the scheme is 8 plus 12, and in that variety we can find out 12 syllabled line common in the first. It is known as Pura Ushnik. Then regarding the placing of 12 syllabled line, the name will be changed. Pura Ushnik, that is 12 plus 8 plus 8, and Kagup, 8 plus 12 plus 8. Kagup Ushnik, and another Kagup Nyangushira, that is 11 plus 12 plus 4, and the Pipilika Madhya, Pipilika like the end, how the middle portion of end is less than the head and the head portion and tail portion, like that here 11 6 11, that is the the number of syllables in each line. So that is also some another varieties there. Tanushira is there. Another variety, Ajushtup Garbha is there. Ajushtup Garbha, 5 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8. So, many varieties are also there. And when we are coming to Anushtub, this is generally defined as a 4-lined meter. Each line consists of 8 syllables, and then the total number of syllables in a stanza will be 32. The variety, 6 varieties are coming under Anushtup meter, Anushtup Chandas, that is Maha Padabhangti. That is 6 lines in that variety of Anushtup, 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 6. And Kriti is there, 12 plus 12 plus 8. And Pibilika Madhya, in each and every meter, the chandas, we can find out such a Pibilika Madhya. Then 12, 8, 12. Kavirat, 9 plus 9 plus 12. Nashtaryuba, 9 plus 10 plus 13. Anushtub Virat, 11 plus 11 plus 11. Such varieties we can find out under the group of Anushtup. And next one is Brihadi. This is also a four-lined meter and has 36 syllables. The syllables are arranged generally as 8 plus 8 plus 12 plus 8. That is the common Brihadi. And Purastad Brihadi. And placing of the 12 syllabled line, there has some variety. Purastad Brihadi. Then Purastad. In that variety, the 12 syllabled number is line is coming the first as the first one. So Purastad Brihadi means the meter, the number of syllables there 12 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8. And Upajishtad Brihadi. Then the last one is the 12 syllabled line. Coming 12 syllable 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 12. And Nyangu Sarini, that is also 8 plus 12 plus 8 plus 8. Like so, Skando Grivi is there, Vishama Pada is there, Vishtara Brihadi is there. So many varieties are coming under Urdu Brihadi is there, Pibiliga Madhyama. Then 13 plus 8 plus, like a Pipiliga, like a ant. The middle portion is less syllabled line will come in that variety. So 13 plus 8 plus 13, that is Pibiliga Madhya. Like so many varieties we can find out. And next one is Pankti. This is a five-lined meter. Each line consisting of 8 syllables. Thus, the total number of syllables in a stanza will be 40. That is also 7 varieties coming under this Pankti group, Pankti Chandas. The first one is Vistara Brihadi. Then 4 lines, that is occurring 10 syllables each in each line. Vistara Brihadi, Vistara Pankti. And another one is Sado Brihadi Pankti. 12, 8. Vibarida Pankti, the opposite of the early mentioned meter, that is 8 plus 12 plus 8 plus 12, like that. And the meter Astara Pankti, 8 plus 8, 12 plus 12. And the same Prastara Pankti, 12 plus 12 plus 8 plus 8. Now, regarding the placing of the lines of 12 and 8, syllabled lines, the name is given to the Samstara Pankti means 12, 8, 8, 12. Like, if the opposite is coming, that is 8 plus 12 plus 12 plus 8, that is Vistara Pankti. Like, next meter is Trishtup. The Trishtup has 44 syllables and 4 lines. Each line consists of 12 syllables. Upajagadi Trishtup. So there are in this group eight varieties are there. Abhisarini Trishtup, Virat Sthana, Panktyuttara Trishtup, Virat Purva Trishtup, Virat Roba Trishtup, Jyotishmadi. So many varieties are coming under this variety. Purastad Jyotihi. That is also one variety. That is 4 lines. Regarding the 8 syllabled line, the name was given. 4 lines. Then Purastad Jyotihi. The 8 is coming, the Purastad, first one. 8 plus 12 plus 12 plus 12. Madhya Jyotihi, 12 plus 12 plus 8 plus 12. And Ubarishta Jyotihi, 12 plus 12 plus 12 plus 8. Mahabrihadi, 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 12. Like there are so many Yavamadhya. Then already we mentioned about the Yavamadhya, that 8 plus 8 plus 12 plus 8 plus 8. The middle portion will be larger, syllabled one. And next meter is Jagadi. The Jagadi meter has 48 syllables and four lines. Each line consists of 12 syllables and three divisions regarding the variation of quantity of syllables in each verse of a stanza. If there are six lines with eight syllables, it is known as Mahapankti Jagadi. If the first two lines contain eight syllables, the third line seven syllables, fourth line six syllables, and fifth line 10 syllables, and sixth line 10 syllables, that is 8 plus 8 plus 7 plus 6 plus 10 plus 9, that meter is known as Mahapankti Jagadi. And 8 syllabled and 12 syllabled meters, if there are vyuha also, that type of meters are known as Mahasado Brihadi. Then Adichandas are there. Already we mentioned Adijagadi, Shakuri, Adishakuri, Ashti, Atyashti, like then Adijagadi means 52 syllables. Shakuri has 56 syllables. Adishakuri has 60 syllables. Ashti has 64 syllables. Atyashti has 68 syllables. Dridi has 72 syllables. Adidridi has 76 syllables. Commonly, these 14 meters we can find out in Vedic. Commonly, Rishi Chandas are profusely used, but there are some examples of the Adi Chandas also we can find out. And the Kriti Chandas, 80 syllables, Prakriti, 84, Agriti, 88, Vigriti, 92, Sangriti, 96 syllables, and Abhigriti 100 syllables, and Utkriti has 100 and 4 syllables. And we can these are the commonly the Rishi Chandas, Adi Chandas, and Kriti Chandas, three varieties. And Shavanaka has the Vedic Rigveda Pradishakya's author, he says that there are 5 meters prior to Gayatri, and there Virats also there. Meters, 5 meters prior to Gayatri, they are Ma, Prama, Pratima, Upama, Samma. These are the 5 meters coming prior to the prior to Gayatri. Ma has 4 syllables, Prama has 8 syllables, Pratima has 12 syllables, Upama has 16 syllables, and Samma has 20 syllables. And these are the 5 meters before coming prior to Gayatri. And we have to these are the commonly the meters which was employed in Vedic meters, Vedic hymns, and we have to understand some basic things of the basic rules, syllabic rules, which was used by the Vedic poets, and mentioned in the Rigveda Pradishakya. Rigveda Pratishakya. Let us think about the syllabic rules of such a Vedic meters. Then we can find out some technical terms: Bhurik, Bhurik, Nijrut, Virat, and Swarat, like terms used by Shaunaga or in the Rigveda Pratishakya. Like the Pratishakya text, we can find out such terms. Though the Vedic meters are determined by the number of syllables in a stanza, it is seen that it varies in different cases. Thus, all the 21 meters from Gayatri to Utkriti have four varieties called Nijrut, Bhurik, Swarat, and Virat. If the number of syllables is less than the required number by one, it is known as Nijrut. So the Gayatri has 24 syllables. If one syllable is less in Gayatri meter, that is known as Nijrut Gayatri, like that. If the number is increased by 1, it is called Bhurik. If the number of syllables became less than less in quantity by 2, it is called Virat. If it increases by 2 in number, that variety is known as Swarat. Thus, a stanza having 26 syllables may either be a Swarat Gayatri or a Virat Ushnik. In this context, Rigveda Pratishakya says that the meter of a stanza of the stanza will be determined by the considering the meter that predominates in the sukta in which that stanza is included. If the predominating meter of the sukta is Gayatri, the 26 syllabled stanza will be Swarat Gayatri. If it is Ushnik, the stanza will be Virat Ushnik. Chandrashastra says that Pingala in Chandrashastra says that taking into account the nature of the first line, the meter of the stanza can be determined. If the first line is Gayatri, it is Swarat Gayatri. If the first line is Ushnik, it is Virat Ushnik. And another syllabic rule, one term is used in Vedic meters, that is Vyoha. In what is meant by Vyoha? That we have to understand from the Rigveda Pratishakya itself. It is to be specially mentioned here that the prosodists have interpreted Vyoha while discussing the syllabic rules. If a doubt arises while locating meters by Pada, Vritta and Akshara, the Akshara supersedes others. In Rigveda Pratishakya, it is mentioned as follows. Aksharanyeva sarvatra nimittam balavattaram vidyad vipratibannanam pada vritta akshara aksharir rajam. If there is a shortage of syllables in a line, it may be compensated by uttering the vowel separately, which are the Egakshara in combination. In Rig Sarvani Kramani, Katyayana defines Vyoha as follows. Pada Puranartam tu Kshaipra Samyogaihi Egakshara Egakshari Bhava Vyuhed. Shavanaga also attest this view. Vyuhad egakshari bhavan padeshuneshu sambade. By adding suitable vowel in between the combinations of ya, ra, la and va, two syllables can be formed. For example, varsham, varisham, varenyam, Varenyam, Trembagam, Triambagam, Tanve, Tanuve. These are the examples. In this way, Vyuha occupies an important role in the Vedic meters, which are made up of prescribed number of syllables, splitting them if necessary. In Gayatri Mantra, Gayatri Mantra, Om Tatsavidur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahim Dhyo Yona Prajodayat. In Tatsavidur Varenyam, then we can find out seven letters. We have to seven syllables. We have needed eight syllables to the Vedic, that is Gayatri. So we have to make a Vyuha. Then Varenyam. So, Om Tat Savidur Varenyam when we are splitting varenyam as varenyam, we can get we can get 8 syllables in that we can find 8 syllables in that line in that pada. And the one is syllabic one technique used in Vedic meters, that is praghada. Praghada, that is strophe. Praghada, otherwise known as strophe, consists of the combination of a kakup or brihadi stanza with the sadobrihadi stanza. If the first stanza is brihadi, it is called barhada praghada. If it is kakup, it is named kakupa praghada. Thus, if that is brihadi, then barhada praghada. Where there are one Anushtup and two Gayatri, it is Anushtupa Pragada. Generally, the Pragadas are named by the Chandas of the first mantra. But sometimes both the Chandas may be mentioned in the name. For example, a Pragada with Gayatri and Brihadi is called Gayatra Barhadaha, thus Gayatra Kagubaha. Pangta Gagubaha, etc. are also seen. In this way, we can, in Vedic Rigveda, we can find out 16 varieties of pragadas. That is the combination of two meters. Mixing two meters, they are forming another, a new model of meter, new model of chandas. That is known as pragada. And Ushnik with Sadobrihadi is called Anushtubaha. Hello, Aushnigaha. Kagup with Pankti is called Pankta Gagubaha. Mahabrihadi with Mahasadobrihadi is called Mahabarhadaha. Brihadi with Jagadi is called Barhadaha. Brihadi with Adijagadi is called Barhadaha. Brihadi with Yavamadhya is called Barhadaha. Brihadi with Vibarida is called Vibaridanda Pragada. Pragada is also added with each and every name. Anishtubh with Jagadi is called Anishtubha Jagadi. Dvibada with Brihadi is called Dvibada Brihadi. Kagup with Brihadi is called Kaguba Barhadaha. Anishtubh with Ushnik is called Anishtubha Aushnigaha. Brihadi with Anishtubh is called Barhada Anishtubaha. Anushtub with Pankti is called Anushtubha Panktaha. Kagup with Trishtub is called Kaguba Trishtubaha. Anushtub with Trishtub is called Anushtubha Trishtubaha. Gayatri with Trishtub is called Jagadaha. Like 16 varieties we can find out in Rigvedic passages. That is kind of mixing of lines of different kind of chandas. Chandasas. Yeah, and the term vritta we can find out. The in classical time period, we the meters are known as vritta, but in Vedic Rigvedic Pradishakya itself, we can find out the term of vritta, and that is also some important thing. That in Vedic period also they are aware about the concept of vritta. We can find out from the Rigveda Pradishakya. If a line has 8 syllables, that line is generally known as Gayatram. 10 syllabled line is called Vairajam. The 11 syllabled line and 12 syllabled line are all called Traishtubham and Jagadam respectively. Then one line itself they have given names already. If it is also said that in Gayatram and Jagadam, the syllable preceding the last one in the line should be a laghu. Shaunaga says that in Vedic mantras, this rule is called vrittam. Vrittas of each chandas in the hymns are framed in the above mentioned pattern of Guru and Laghu. Similarly, Vairaja and Traishtubha, the syllable preceding the last one should be a Guru. Then ഋഗ്വേദ പ്രാതിശാഖ്യ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് യൂസ്ഡ് ദ ഉപോത്തമം അക്ഷരം ദ പ്രിസൈഡിംഗ് സിലബിൾ ഓഫ് ദി ലാസ്റ്റ് വൺ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഉപോത്തമം അക്ഷരം ദ ആർ യൂസിംഗ് ദാറ്റ് ദി എബോവ് ഐഡിയ ഇൻഡിക്കേറ്റ്സ് ദാറ്റ് ദ കോൺസെപ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് വൃത്ത ഡിപെൻഡ്സ് അപ്പോൺ ദ പാറ്റേൺ ഓഫ് ഗുരു ആൻഡ് ലഘു ഇൻ ക്ലാസിക്കൽ സാൻസ്ക്രിറ്റ് ദ മീറ്റേഴ്സ് ആർ ഫുള്ളി ഡിറ്റർമിൻഡ് ബൈ ദ പാറ്റേൺ ഓഫ് ഗുരു ആൻഡ് ലഘു ആൻഡ് ദേ ആർ കോൾഡ് വൃത്തം So, Vedic, the Vedic prosodists have aware about the concept of Vritta, which is determined by the pattern of Guru and Lekhu. And in the case of the deciding the lines also, the method of deciding the lines of Riks also, they have made some theories. Shavanaka has pointed out certain rules for deciding the lines in a rigs. From the three-lined rigs, the rules begin as follows. If the three-lined rigs, there should be an ending at the end of both the second line and the third line. But sometimes instead of this, the above ending is suggested at the conclusion of the first line and the remaining two lines. In the four lined rig, the ending should be at the end of second and the fourth lines respectively. Otherwise, after the third and fourth lines, the stop shall come. The ending may come at the end of the first line and the fourth line. There are so many varieties they have given. In the five lined rigs, the ending shall be at the end of the second, fourth and fifth lines. Ending may also be after third and second or second and third lines respectively. In the six line rig, the ending can come at the end of second, fourth and sixth lines or at the end of third and sixth or second and sixth lines also. In the seven line rig, endings usually come at the end of third, fifth and seventh lines respectively or at the end of the third and seventh lines. The ending may come after the second and seventh lines also in the seven lined rigs. In the eight lined rigs, the general rule regarding the endings is that it can come at the end of second, fifth and eighth lines respectively. And the above mentioned divisions and subdivisions of meters are solely based on the external structure of the stanzas. The earlier writers on Vedic prosody like Katyayana and Shavanaka have defined and illustrated the different varieties of meters, mainly taking into account the number of syllables. Katyayana states that the chandas is determined by the number of syllables only. Yadakshara parimanam tachandaha. The quantitative nature of the syllables like hraswa and dirgha, short and long respectively, and yadi inside the lines was not accepted by them as determining aspects of meters. And in Vedic meters, E. Vernon Arnold, who has done an in-depth study on the metrical characteristics of Vedic stanzas, uphold that the Vedic rishis who composed the mantras were well aware of the internal form or the rhythmic nature of them also. He states there are a few parts of the verses in which the poets do not consider themselves free at times to depart from the usual rhythms. So that it may perhaps be said that there are no rules of rhythm in Rigveda. He also points out that the arrangement of gurus and lekhus in metric lines and the positioning of yati, which are the dominant features of the meters like Trishtup and Jagadi, have a considerable role in constituting the internal form of rhythm or the Vedic meters, though that were not expressly discussed in the works on prosody of Vedic texts.